I wanted so badly to get on here and say, I edited this video on Final Cut for iPad. I just couldn't do it. Don't get me wrong, Final Cut for iPad has some incredible features. Its multicam editing is great. Things like auto crop and the remove background. These are some awesome features, especially those getting into video editing or trying to go to the next level. But as someone who spends a lot of time in Final Cut Pro on the Mac editing multiple videos a week, I just could not get to editing on the iPad. Now, when it comes to traveling, or maybe I took a bunch of video with my iPhone for a trip and I just want to edit it quickly, I'll definitely be using Final Cut Pro for iPad. It's great for that, especially those quick edits. But if you're like me and you have some long-established habits in Final Cut on Mac, you're just not going to be able to edit quickly on Final Cut for iPad, and there are two key features that I think Apple missed in Final Cut for iPad that just makes it a non-starter for me in day-to-day use. I'll get to those in a second. First off, I think Apple did a great UI of adapting Final Cut to the iPad. I think it's interesting they changed the terminology of events on Final Cut for Mac to projects as the top-level hierarchy, and then when you jump into a project, you can actually create multiple timelines. Totally down for that change. I will say the multicam editing in Final Cut is pretty amazing. You can edit the angles, add angles after you've created a multicam clip, sync it all. Two thumbs up for that. That's actually how I do most of my videos, where I have my audio recorded separately, I create a multicam clip, and then I can make changes to the video here in the multicam clip and it affects the entire project. Also, one of the new features in Final Cut Pro on iPad that isn't on the Mac is this auto crop feature. I will definitely be using this a lot to make shorts out of my long form video. If you select a clip, tap Inspect, then go over to the Crop menu here. You can go to Crop Tools, and there you'll see Auto Crop. And then Auto Crop will attempt to follow the subject of the video, so it's easy to create a vertical clip focusing on the subject from your long form video. The other feature Apple touted was this Remove Background. Tap a clip, hit Inspect, go over to this menu. Under Masks and Keys, you can then add Scene Removal Mask. Again, in my situation, probably because of my background, it did not do a great job of cutting me out. And I understand it's a hard problem to solve, especially with a busy background, but TikTok can do it, and I've used Runway ML to create a green screen effect on videos that I've filmed in this studio, and it actually works really well. Apple just has to tweak that scene removal mask in order for it to work in more environments. Now, I'm not going to go super in-depth on all the other features for Final Cut. There are some great videos out there, especially from Tyler Stallman and Christopher Lawley. I'll link those videos down in the description. Watch those if you just want a complete walkthrough of Final Cut for iPad. But I want to cover two things that make it difficult for me personally to use Final Cut on iPad on a daily basis. Number one, you cannot edit footage off an external SSD. I store all of my footage on SSDs, and then I transfer those projects to my Synology for long-term storage. And I keep the footage on this SSD. I don't like copying that footage to my Mac and editing it locally there, then transferring it later. I just want to keep the footage here, import it on here, edit from here, and it's a Thunderbolt drive. It's super fast. I'll put a link to this Envoy Pro FX SSD drive. I have a couple of these and they're just amazing for editing video. Thunderbolt connection, super fast data speeds. And the iPad Pro does have a Thunderbolt connector, and so there's plenty fast data transfers from my external SSD to the iPad. This is something that apps like LumaFusion on iPad can already do. I can point LumaFusion to a specific folder on this external SSD drive. Yes, it's called Rohan. Let's say I point it to this folder, I can open it, and now LumaFusion will let me edit the footage directly off the SSD without importing it into the app. I don't have to save the video files locally to my iPad. When working in Final Cut on iPad, you can access those external SSD drives and import the footage into Final Cut, but it will copy it locally to the iPad. You can't leave the footage on the SSD drive and just edit it over a cable. You have to import it to the physical device. This would require a lot of file management and moving stuff around. You can see one of my YouTube videos, I have over 70 gigabytes of footage, and that doesn't include all the B-roll I might add later. So we're talking 100 gigabytes per project for a professional video. If I wanted to use the iPad as my main Final Cut device, that means I'll have to be managing projects and moving files on an almost every other day basis. And I have the 1 terabyte iPad version, and you can get it in 2 terabytes, so maybe you can save a few more projects, but that kind of file management all the time and then having to figure out how to get all this footage back into Final Cut on my Mac and maybe onto my Synology, I think that goes to serve the point that Apple made Final Cut on iPad for those really editing video for social media, maybe those vertical video clips, or doing things on the go. This is not really intended for professional video editors sitting at a desk that are used to editing on their Mac with Final Cut full time. Again, great features like that auto crop and the multicam, Apple really built some powerful tools into Final Cut on iPad, but even that one file management quirk makes it difficult to want to use this full time. Now, because LumaFusion can already do it, it's not a limitation of the physical iPad device or even iPad OS. So Apple could add this feature later, but for some reason they decided with this initial launch that you have to import all video footage locally to your iPad. So that's challenge number one. Number two, I was really looking forward to editing on the iPad because I already use Apple Pencil and Ferrite to edit audio podcasts on iPad, and I love doing it. I love being able to sit on my patio, and editing with the Apple Pencil is super fast. One of the ways it's so fast to edit on iPad, especially for podcasts, is here in Ferrite, I can select a section quickly with the Apple Pencil and just delete it, move all the tracks over, and that ability to make super fast edits and everything just moves back in place, it's so convenient. Now, Final Cut already has a magnetic timeline, so I was looking forward to be able to just delete a section real quick and have it kind of work like Ferrite, but that is just simply not the case. There's no kind of like selecting a section with the Apple Pencil and being able to move it quickly. I would also love just the playhead to jump to wherever I tap the pencil, but instead I have to tap up here and then you can select a clip, and there are some tools down here like trim everything up to the playhead, and that's okay, but man, it would be so much easier if I could just drag with my Apple Pencil and delete a section of the video, have the entire timeline magnetically snap to it. It would make editing so much faster. Now, Apple Pencil Hover is kind of cool because you can scrub through footage without even touching the iPad, and then you can tap to jump to a certain part in a clip here up in the inspector, and you can also scrub even down here in the timeline, and that's a cool pencil feature. But I feel like there's way more potential to use the pencil specifically for editing on iPad, and it's just kind of missed. Now, these are all features Apple could add later with the Apple Pencil, but I would really love just a settings pane that lets me customize how the pencil interacts with Final Cut to make editing really fast. If I could edit videos like I edit podcasts in Ferrite, that would be a game changer. Also, I really wish Apple would have carried over a few keyboard shortcuts that I use in my workflow. For instance, I'll hit the R key in Final Cut here on Mac, select a range of the clip here in the timeline, and then hit delete. In case you didn't know, that deletes the footage you just selected with the range tool, and then the magnetic timeline snaps back into place. Here in Final Cut on iPad, there is a range tool, but hitting the R key doesn't bring it up. And when you hold the command key to see all the different keyboard shortcuts, there are a few of them, but I don't see the range tool as a hotkey, or even the blade tool. Again, on the Mac, if I just hit the letter B, I get the blade tool and I can cut my footage right there. Hitting B on the Magic Keyboard doesn't bring up the blade tool, and it's not always intuitive how to get it here in Final Cut on iPad. For instance, that's the blade tool in the bottom right corner, and if I scrub over a clip that's not selected, it just disappears. I have to actually click a clip and then move the playhead, and then I can click the blade tool to separate it. It would just be really nice if I could hit the letter B and then cut a clip, but that's not the case. All that being said, some of the other unique features like the live drawing, this is really cool. This is gonna be great, especially for social media type things. You can see the live drawing creates a new clip that's kind of overlaid here in the timeline, and you can see it kind of animates in. And Apple did include powerful tools like voice isolation and a lot of granular control per clips. There's some quirkiness about copy and pasting settings across multiple clips, and that can be frustrating if you're used to Final Cut on Mac. But there are other cool ideas too, like this jog wheel that lets you actually scrub between the footage, and you can even scrub clips up here, which is really cool. Even set the in point and then out point, and then you can add it on top of the timeline or append, and there you go, it jumps right on top there. Really, really cool. I will say, I think Apple has added enough features into Final Cut Pro where if you didn't want to take your MacBook Pro on a trip and still edit some video, you could do it. You definitely want to get a large iPad, like 1 terabyte or 2 terabytes, especially if you're dealing with like mirrorless camera footage. If you're going to be importing from SD cards, you're going to need a lot of storage on here because you can't edit off external drives. But if you're doing filming from your iPhone or directly on iPad and you want a quick way to edit that footage while you're on the go, Final Cut on iPad is going to be a great solution. And I will be using it to make those vertical clips for social media like TikTok and Instagram Reels. I can import my finished renders for my long form videos, use that auto crop feature, and making those 30 to 60 second clips will be much faster. So really thankful for that feature. But I'm hoping that as Final Cut progresses on iPad, and this is the very first version, it just came out, but that Apple adds more editing features to the Apple Pencil, more granular control for how it will function in the timeline, and the ability to edit off external SSD drives, that would just be a huge addition. Again, if you want a full walkthrough of Final Cut for iPad, I'll link some of the videos below that I've watched, and they have incredible tutorials. And if you've never used Final Cut on Mac, but you want to upgrade from iMovie, or all you have is an M1 iPad and you don't have a Mac, Final Cut Pro is an incredible value. $5 a month, $50 a year, but you still get that incredible multicam editing. You have so much control over your different clips. The auto crop feature, live draw, it is an incredible application, and thankful that Final Cut is finally on this device. I do think calling this an iPad Pro, that's a little more legitimized now that we actually have pro apps like Final Cut and Logic Pro 10. I'm glad it's here. I will be using it for those vertical clips and auto crop. And when I'm traveling, I think I will edit on Final Cut for iPad and leave my MacBook Pro at home. Let me know what you think if you've tried Final Cut for iPad. Leave a comment below this video. Like and subscribe to the channel. Lots of tech reviews coming out on the channel, especially smart home devices. And WWDC is coming up soon. There's probably going to be some big announcements. I'll cover the biggest ones right here on the channel. Thanks for tuning in. And maybe check out one of these videos that's coming up right here.